You are welcome to Teapart Online Jupe Tutorial. I'm your tutor for today. My name is Kelechi. I'll be taking CHMO2. I know you are familiar with chemistry, and for your Jupe program, split it into CHMO1, CHMO2, CHMO3, and CHMO4. O1 is inorganic chemistry, O2 is physical chemistry, O3 is the periodic table chemistry, and O4 is organic chemistry. So today I'll be taking CHMO2, a very important chemistry in the whole of chemistry, because it's physical chemistry. And physical chemistry, for students that do such course, they do have issues there. So now I'm trying to address many of these issues here by taking CHMO2 today. And I'll be taking chemical kinetics. What is chemical kinetics? Chemical kinetics deals with the speed of chemical reactions. In layman terms, it means how fast or how slow a chemical reaction is. And more importantly, and the elucidation of mechanisms. What I mean by the elucidation of mechanism, I mean that now if you have a reaction 2H2 plus O2 giving us 2H2O, we know this is the formation of water. Water does not just form like this, because hydrogen, oxygen reacting to give us water. We need to know that, is this reaction going to be fast? Is it going to be slow? Also, we need to also consider the fact that this reaction, is it a stepwise reaction? Because you can have step one, you can have step two. And the fact that you have step one, step two is what leads to elucidation of mechanism of chemical reactions. Now, what are the factors that affect chemical reactions? Number one is temperature. Temperature, very, very important. Temperature. That is why you observe in chemistry labs, in your labs, you see that we tell you that you should do this in cold water bath, hot water, do this, do that, because of what? Temperature. It affects a chemical reactions. So we need to know one important thing, that as temperature increases, chemical reaction will also what? Increase. I think that again. But quickly, let me quickly show a chemical reaction, so we can quickly note that in our book. That as temperature increases, the rates of reaction also increase. So it is a direct relationship. It's a direct relationship. And that is why you observe when you are very hungry and you get back home, you can easily on your gas, increase your gas, and quickly what? Cook your indomie. Why? Because you have increased temperature, and you expect that the rate of reaction to also what? Increase. Secondly is pressure or concentration. Pressure or concentration. Now, pressure concentration, you need to know something that is very, very important. They are, you say, are pressure, are they the same? They are similar. So we need to know that as they increase, they expect chemical reaction to also what? Increase too. Now, let me take you to some important thing there. Very, very important. I will quickly clean this part. Let me quickly clean this part. I want to show you a curve. I must always note, and this is the curve here. Now, if we consider maybe concentration with time, we observe that if you have an amount of a substance, as time increases, we observe that the rate of the reaction will what? Will going down. Why? Because you observe that as the reaction increases, as the rate of reaction increases, the concentration will keep on what? Decreasing for reactants. Because why? Because the reactant is being consumed in the course of a chemical reaction. And we observe that the product is now being formed. So you can have A. That is, if I have A plus B giving me C. So A, B are reactants. And with time, we observe that what? They will what? To keep on decreasing. And we expect C, which is the product, to keep on what? Increasing. And now, another factor that affects rate of reaction is light. Light. Now, light is very, very important. Light is very, very important. That's why you look at your biology in your WAEC. Remember that when you put beans in a cupboard, you close the environment, you observe that if you open a hole, the beans grow towards the part that there's light. Now, we have taken the last one, which is catalyst. But for today, we stop at catalyst. And I believe that everybody here is very, very happy with what I've done here so far. And I would like everyone to take part or to take notes that the class continues next time. Thank you.